but she disappeared. She said, we were there in a fairy tale castle. But now I'm it all around you. Good love and gone bad.
Like a bumblebee. That's okay to see how you do it. going to be towed, I guess? I don't know. I'm just thinking, okay, there's a gray Pontiac there.
When are you going to be serious about it?
When are you going to quit being psychic on the stage, right?
I can't help it. But really, the gray Pontiac is
coming from. Thank you.
My mom's not here. My grand here. Okay.
Hey, Daddy. Mommy, no one got this
too. What do you want to hear?
Let's do some butternut squash.
Good.
Butternut squash.
I guess everybody's kind of wondering why we wrote a song about butternut squash. This is why, right here. And I want Laura to explain why this is why.
I've got a very special presentation to make.
Ladies and gentlemen, Meyer Horn.
Why, thank you.
Torso's not as big as mine, but he is Meyer Horn, and he's a really good drummer.
That was really sweet. When we had our CD release party in February, I guess it was. Speaking of CDs, I wish y'all would buy one of the remaining ones we have left before you go if you don't have it. They're $10 at the door, but that's not important right now. I'm trying to get this caught in the fan. This shovel was given to me in February, and it really means a lot to me because not only does it symbolize the band, you know, the dig thing and everything, but that symbolism is pretty evident. But, I'd like to give this shovel back to its rightful owner, but before I do that, I want to demonstrate something. This is not a regular shovel, and as you can see, it's a snow shovel, which I have no use for. But,
did you say snow?
Yeah.
And farm? Sorry. I'm really into that song, so I'm sorry about that. Thank you, dum dum.
See, if you notice, there's something very special about this shovel.
Oh, no!
I know.
There's a bend in the handle of the shovel.
Oh, my God!
Yeah, I know.
It's an ergonomic one.
Okay. The reason there's a bend in the handle of the shovel, I'm going to make this quick, is that when you have a shovel with a straight handle, you end up having to bend your back when you do backbreaking work. But when there's a bend in the handle of the shovel, the shovel does the bending for you. But anyway, I'd like to give the shovel back to its rightful owner, and that's Mr. David Rogers.
Hey! I've relaxed the back store. The Relax the Back Store is a really neat store. Go there.
David was my boss this year at the Relax the Back Store. I worked at the Relax the Back Store, 38th and Lamar Street. We've got a little song for him.
Kit and I wrote the jingle for the Relax the Back Store. David hasn't heard this yet. You may be hearing this on KGSR one day. How's it going? Now Jack and Jill went up a hill. Wait.
That's right.
Jack and Jill went up the hill. That's right. Jack and Jill went up the hill. Notice how the melody didn't change the key, but I did change the keys of the chords. That's art. So Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a water bottle. Jack, that's your line, Kit.
I'm sorry, let's start over.
Now Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch the water bottle.
Jack's foot missed, meets with the disc, and now he's horizontal.
Jill said,
"Dear, now don't you fear, you just threw it out of whack."
Hey, Jill.
Hey, Jack.
Relax the back.
Ooh, ah. Ooh, ah.
So you've all got everything you're looking for.
From healing hair to healing notions, we got all kinds of soothing lotions. Some just like to sit and stare in our therapeutic massage chair.
Hey, Jill, sing along.
Hey, Jack.
The subject of squash, you know, the conversation just diverges. Happens to me all the time. Does anybody have a good squash story? All right, let's hear it. What happened to you? No squash stories. All right. Okay, let's play it. All right.
Butternut Thank you.
I have a bumper sticker here. One of these really neat, those who dig bumper stickers, appropriate for home or office. For the first person who will kindly raise their hand and tell me. Hey, Grossman, where are you? Grossman, get me another drink. And me too. All right, first person can tell me what the two shows, The Facts of Life and Hello Larry, have in common.
Hey,
on our CD. We're practically giving them away tonight for $10. Thank you.
standing on a bridge and he's floating under his toe. So just walking from the town, striving for to live.